This woodturner has been carving wood for almost half a century. The expert movement of his fingertips draws out the beautiful wood grain. He turns the lathe with a desire to discover the stunning patterns nature created. The attractive finished products take on character as they age.
500年先の人が、僕じゃなくて物と対話してくれれば嬉しい。
Tea culture inspired Kyoto woodcraft. Within these items, made using various techniques, is a simple beauty that exudes the spirit of simplicity and serenity which the world of tea embodies.
人に見ていただいた時にある程度こう感動してもらうような心を打つようなもの作りっていうのを目指してますんで。
A cooper makes innovative products for modern life using 700-year-old barrel-making techniques. Kyoto artisans pursue the inherent beauty of wood. They create everyday items using the abundant varieties of trees available in Japan. Core Kyoto unravels the woodworkers' diligence and the awe they have for the wood they work. Kyoto, the old capital for 1,200 years. Under the patronage of the aristocrats and temples, woodcraft flourished and Kyoto attracted expert craftsmen from around the nation. In time, they each concentrated on certain objects, and these specialized fields survive today. This workshop stands in a residential area in the city center. The air is fragrant with the scent of timber. Yuki Ayabe works a lathe to carve wood. The finished items, called hikimono, have a velvety touch and elegant curves. This technique maximizes the natural designs found in timber. Ayabe, who has been in the trade since 1966, is making a round container to hold trinkets. He attaches the timber to the lathe and carves it with a blade as it rotates. The lathe is controlled using foot pedals. He adjusts the speed at which the timber rotates as he works. Subtly adjusting the angle of the chisel, he constantly searches for the ideal speed for the quality of the material and the object he is making. If he lets down his guard for a split second, the chisel makes a deep groove in the wood and the object is ruined. So this process requires delicate expertise. But there is much more to a wood turner's job.
Konnichiwa. Ah, itsumo sumimasen. Osewa ni natte arigatou gozaimasu.
Ayabe is visiting the local lumber shop. For a turner, wood is everything. This shop stores around 30 varieties of selected wood for Ayabe.
Broadleaf
wood has a tendency to bend, distort, and warp. So the timber must be properly dried, naturally, before it is used. This takes at least 10 years. And depending on the object to be made, sometimes more than 30.
この辺が細かいことは成長が遅いってことですね。ゆっくりゆっくり大きくなっていくので、急に大きくなったやつはどうも人間と一緒で弱いところがあります。
Ayame made these pieces from carefully selected sturdy broadleaf timber. The natural patterns in the grain reveal each tree's history. This tray is made from Japanese ash, which has an extremely fine grain. This incense container is made from Chinese mulberry. As Ayabe carved the old tree, he discovered a fantastic grain. This deep-colored container for weak-flavored tea is made from Japanese cedar, which lay in the ground for 3,000 years. In the hands of a turner, even this decayed wood is transformed into a wondrous object. Persimmon wood, resin-filled pine, and aged pine, each has distinct alluring qualities. Another integral part of a wood turner's job is forging his tools. The lathe chisels and spear planes required are special tools that are not available for sale. Ayabe uses bellows to stoke the fire as he tempers the steel to suit his purpose.
Handmade
tools help create precise and intricate articles. Ayabe switches lathe chisels as he turns, and the object slowly takes shape from a block of Japanese zelkova wood. The delicate carving softens the masculine fine grain of the zelkova in this finished trinket container.
やはりいつまでも何百年と使えるものを作る、これも一番大きな要素だと思います。
名前が残るんじゃなくて、作ったものが100年、200年、300年、500年先の人が僕じゃなくてものと対話してくれれば嬉しい。
Wood turners spin their lathes in search of the ultimate in design. Established more than a century ago, this restaurant specializes in local Kyoryori cuisine.It began serving what was to become its specialty 45 years ago.
お待たせいたしました。手置き弁当でございます。
Delicate Kyoto cuisine is presented in a pail, a novel idea that highlights the wood.
瀬戸門で二度つきとはまた違う、真っ白なもんですから、非常に生地に持った場合お料理が映えますし、生地の美しさ大切さが京都にも合ってると思うんですね。
Containers bound by metal hoops are called tagamono. These have been an indispensable part of Japanese life for centuries.Shuji Nakagawa has been producing tagamono for 24 years. His father, Kiyotsugu, invented the teoke or pail used for food presentation and is a living national treasure. Shuji is continuing the family business his grandfather started.Outside the workshop are numerous varieties of raw conifer wood. It is the main material used in many everyday tagamono utensils due to its water resistance. To whiten the raw timber, it is exposed to the elements to remove the oils and other substances.The more than 300 planes that line the workshop walls are used according to the variety and size of the timber. They range in size down to this tiny plane.
結局木ってもうまさに人間と一緒で一本一本違うんで、一人一人違うように一本一本違うんで、その新しい木を買ったらまた今までに経験したことないような部分っていうのがどうしても。その出てくるんで、それを知ってそれにこういかに対応していくかっていうのを考えながらものづくりしてますね。
Most of Nakagawa's work involves making the same goods his grandfather did. He produces a range of more than 200 items from tubs to vases.One of the Nakagawa's standard items is the wooden barrel. When making a barrel, Nakagawa first rounds dried blocks of sawara cypress on the insides and outsides with crescent-shaped blades.He uses a measure to adjust the angle and make sure the side plates join perfectly together. Not even a 0.1 millimeter error is permissible.
これ正直っていう作業で、仕事をほんまに正直にしないと、結果ここを怠けるとその桶になった時に水が漏れてしまうんで、嘘がバレるっていうんで、正直に仕事をしろっていうふうな、そういう言われ方をしたこともあるんですけども。
He hammers in bamboo nails and assembles the pieces so the grain aligns. He then carefully works to make the seams as invisible as possible. He fits the hoops. then inserts the bottom piece last. It fits perfectly to make the barrel watertight. Three generations have strived to create traditional wooden pails. Despite the pail being an everyday object, it contains a graceful, simple beauty.
60年前に祖父がやってた時に桶屋が200軒以上あった。で、今が3、4軒残っていく技術として僕はこうやっていきたいっていうふうに思ってて、そのためにいろんな新しいことへの挑戦っていうのをしてますね。
This wine cooler is exemplar of his flair. It is made of hinoki cypress wood, which is waterproof and suitable for insulation. Going against convention for ordinary pails, it has an elliptical shape and a sharp rim. The shape of each of the parts in this design is subtly different. Nakagawa is happy with the result after many trial efforts. This Ikebana vase has an innovative design using podocarp wood and 1,500-year-old cedar bogwood. These cups are for sake and beer. Nakagawa is creating tagamono products to suit the times. He is, however, not only dedicated to producing new products. He also accepts items for repair and maintenance. Customers send him barrels and tubs that have sentimental value.
京都の人っていうのはやっぱりこういうものすごく大事にされるんで、ほんまにうちのおばあちゃんとかひいばあちゃんが嫁入りの時に持ってきたものやから大事に使って直してあげてって言って持ってこられる方っていうのも多いですね。
Nakagawa honors tradition, yet he continues to create novel tagamono items that draw out the beauty, softness, and strength of wood. Woodcrafts developed in the ancient capital as the utensils used in tea gatherings evolved. The world of tea values the spirit of simplicity and serenity. So practitioners desire a natural, simple charm emphasized by the innate character of wood in the utensils and fittings they use. Ohara, in Kyoto's north. Based in this lush natural environment is Koshun Kawamoto, a tea utensil sashimono craftsman. Sashimono is a joinery technique that fits together pieces of wood without the use of nails. A protuberance called a hozo is made at the end of one piece of wood and a cavity in the other. They are then fitted together. This traditional method was developed to strengthen joints. This frame was made to fit around a firebox in a tea gathering room. It is not only decorative, but also prevents sparks landing on the straw tatami mats. Kawamoto moved his workshop to Ohara 20 years ago because he wanted to be inspired by nature.
まあ、空気ももちろんいいし、あの近くに川があったりして、あのいわゆるまあ子どもが自然に遊ぶようなところっていうのは、あのものづくりにやっぱり適しているところなんで、あの、まあ、街中とはやっぱりちょっと一味も二味も違った感じですね。ここはあの材木倉庫なんですけど、私とこのそのメインのこれが桑の木です。
Chinese mulberry is extremely hard and difficult to work. Sashimono craftsmen who handle this wood are much respected by their peers. Successive generations of the Kawamoto family have used it to produce tea utensils.
非常に硬いんですけど、ある部分だけはちょっと粘りのあるところがあって、その粘りのあるところはあの曲げたりして加工するんですけどね、大体その材木で基本的に曲げませんのでね、それをまあ無理に曲げて、それでまあ工芸として一つの作品に仕上げていくんですけど、本当に一部分だけ曲がるところがあるんです。
He has begun work on a tea utensil from Chinese mulberry, which is expensive because it can be hard to come by.He repeatedly soaks the piece he cut in hot water, slowly bending it a little more each time. Discerning the best place to bend the timber is most difficult. Kawamoto uses his years of experience and intuition to find it. The timber could split if he is not careful. After an hour, the bent piece of wood is fixed over an arch-shaped mold and dried for 4 days.The finished tobacco tray holds the various implements used in smoking shredded tobacco. As it ages, Chinese mulberry takes on a dark appearance, as seen in the tray on the right made a decade ago. Though tea gatherings are today non-smoking affairs, the tray is still an important object. In the tea ceremony room, the rich color lends a rusticity to which the world of tea aspires.Kawamoto also places much value on used materials from shrines and temples.
これが京都の上賀茂神社の、おそらく500年ぐらいは経ってるであろうって言われる杉の木です。これが東本願寺の門かどこかにあったんじゃないかなって言われてるヒノキですね。あの上の材木があの京都の大徳寺のあれ松ですね。材木も随分乾いてますから、あのいわゆる乾かさなくてもすぐ、まあ、使えるという、まあ、利点と、とにかくね、そのそこの場所に長年あったと。例えばお寺だったらお寺の何百年という歴史があって、まあ、物は言いませんけど、いろんなものを見てきてますんで、いわゆる木が入ってるんですね。人間の木っていうのがこの中に入ってるんです。だからその木をあのまた道具に変えて、物に変えて、ずっとまあ使えるようにしてあげるっていう、まあ、こっちもある意味魂入れるわけです。
This is a tray Kawamoto made from the 500-year-old Japanese cedar tree from Kamigamo Jinja's shrine precincts. The tray is used for serving confections during tea gatherings.Kawamoto uses a certain technique for the joints on the reverse of the tray. He cuts a notch in the joint and inserts a thin sliver of wood called a chigiri to reinforce it. He pares the excess away so the joint is unnoticeable.
お茶室でやっぱり一番大事な道具は床の間の軸ですね。でお茶碗であったり、それから茶器であったり、私の作ってるようなものは他のものを引き立てるというための存在のものなんです。それがあることによって前に置いてある道具がこうバーッと輝くわけですね、まあ、極端に言えば。
Sashimono tea utensils hold a refined yet simple beauty, and their striking appearance enhances the atmosphere of tea rooms. Sashimono techniques are also used to produce lamps that emit soft light and throw graceful shadows. This building firm specializes in Sukiya teahouse style construction. It makes lighting products for rooms and buildings used for tea gatherings. Sukiya construction is characterized by bare simplicity, conforming to tea room standards. Therefore, unobtrusive lighting is preferred to create a refined ambience.
そのデザイン的には見た目にシンプルっていうのが、まあ、京都の特徴なんですけれども、シンプルの中でも、まあ、建物と同じくらいの寿命を持たせるために線の細い中に、複雑なこう敷地を作るっていうことが、まあ、一つの技術ではあるんですけれどもね。
Torihara has put much study into making sturdier joints and has devised original methods for joining several pieces of woodto be used in conjunction with traditional techniques. Behind the simple appearance hides precision craftsmanship. The lights are a fusion of new and old sashimono techniques. The aesthetic sensibilities cultivated in Kyoto continue to mature.Different timber has different traits. Kyoto woodcraft produces refined objects that draw out the natural designs that took nature years to generate. The craftsmen feel reverence toward the material in their hands. They strive to create novel items using intricate techniques handed down for generations.Behind the gracefulness of Kyoto woodcraft hides the affectionate gaze of the Kyoto craftsman.